We're 4 hours and 41 minutes into the build, and a phone is starting to emerge. There's a receiver, a dial complete with mechanism, electrics, bell and case. Marvellous.
Yeah. Now, what I'll do next is put the dial on, and in fact I need to go back to my table of pieces to get the 5 tiny little screws that hold that together. Now, these are some of the smaller screws in the telephone. Look. Tiny little screw.
It's only now, after 5 hours, that the 211 separate, mostly minuscule components that I started with have turned into something reassuringly phone-shaped.
Now, this, I think, if I've got this right, these two little... I'm not even sure what I would call those. Are they tabs? They will go through those slight cutouts in the Bakelite, and then I will give it a little bit of a turn, and that will lock it in place behind that edge, and I will put the screw in, the awkward screw from the bottom, and that will be the dial in. Yeah, you see, that's locked into place, but we've got to put that little screw in. Right, I'm expected to get a screw. That's very awkward. A magic screwdriver may not help me here. It's very dark inside the 1950s. Hang on, I need a torch. Ah, there you go. I think we're in the position. We're very, very close to telephone closure here. We can put the base on and then insert the little slidey-out tray that has the numbers for the Prime Minister and so on. Here is the small piece of, I imagine that's cellulose acetate or something like that, with its locating pin at the bottom, so you can't put this perfectly blank circular piece of stuff in the wrong position. It only has a wrong position as a result of having the device to make sure you put it in the right position. The 1957 GPO-supplied British domestic Bakelite telephone with an internal bell.